Hi, I'm Joe from It's Okay to Be Smart, and today I'm doing a special collaboration with my friends from Minute Earth. If you lined up the world population of domestic cats, that kitty conga line would wrap nearly 6 times around the planet. Meowadays, there's around 85 million pet cats in the US alone. How did cats become the grumpy, laser-chasing keyboard enthusiasts we know today? And what role did humans play in their transformation? It all started around 11 million years ago in Asia with a cat that looked something like this. We think this ancestor of modern cats traveled far and wide in search of food and mates, an instinct shared across the feline family. Single pumas have been known to patrol nearly 1,000 square kilometers. That's as big an area as 200,000 American football fields. That urge to roam drove early cats over land bridges into new worlds, and species diverged, many of which we'd recognize today. It was the smaller wild cats, at least the ones that survived big upheavals like a changing climate and the onslaught of a certain pesky primate, that eventually became our first feline friends. As we moved away from hunter-gatherer ways and put down roots, food piled up, and this brought other animals like rodents to the table, and cats came strolling in after them. Don't let those big eyes fool you. Felines are murder machines. They're more successful hunters than almost any other predator, and those hunting instincts would have been a big help to our ancestors. Cats that ate rodents but didn't eat children got to stick around. People began getting attached to cats. In fact, a child and cat were buried together in a 9,500-year-old grave in Cyprus. Cats weren't quite getting attached to humans, though. They retained their urge to roam and their killer instinct, and still pretty much looked like their wild cousins. But they were changing. House cats can digest plant matter better than wild cats, helping them make meals of human scraps. What's more, recent changes in genes influencing how cats respond to fear make domestic kitties friendlier than wild cats, even if we still can't exactly train them. The ancient Egyptians worshipped cats as incarnations of a goddess, and many of us take a hieroglyph from their tablet today. Cats may have even learned to demand our attention. In the wild, all kittens meow to mom, but once she stops listening, they move on to other sounds. But house cats never leave their adoring mothers, so the kitten call continues. So how did ferocious felines become perfect pets for millions of us around the world? It all started with the cat who ate the rat who ate the grain that lay in the hut that our ancestors built.
Hey, it's Kate. Thanks to Joe for taking over our channel for this possum video. And let us know how many famous internet cats you recognized in it. If you dig dogs instead, follow me over to Joe's channel, It's Okay to Be Smart, where we help him sniff out the story of humans' real best friend. Make sure to subscribe while you're there.